Do you know Milos? Are you friends with Milos?
Yes, me or him?
Both of you guys. So if you guys know Milos, then you know his insulin protocol. Yep. Before training, during training, after training. Yeah. And he explains it to you with charts and graphs and stuff like that. Yeah. I did that. I did that with him in 2010, I believe it was. I did that with him. Yeah, it gets you massive, but you lose your proportions. You lose, and it's exactly what I'm seeing now. Massive without the proportions. That's what I'm seeing.
Well, Kamali, since you're going back in time here, let's take, I want to take you back to the 94 Collegiate Nationals.
Oh, boy, that's way back.
So, Amin was telling me your conditioning was on a whole other level. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I couldn't breathe. I had no fluid left in my lungs. I wheezed when I, this is the way I sounded for 2 days straight. That's how I was breathing. And thank God Amin was there. Cause Amin, if you guys don't know, he stays very calm during the most very traumatic situations.
Yeah,
he stays calm. Mean. And back then, you know, you wad of dip in his mouth, and you know, he just look at you and he'd be like, "You're fine. Just calm down and go to sleep or something. You're fine. Everything is going to be fine. We're going to show them conditioning." You know, and you hear that in your head, you're like, "Yeah, you know, fuck it." That was the thing with Amin. You just say, "Ah, fuck it. You know, we'll be fine." You know, and to get to that level now, you know, have other people like Munzer and those people. Yeah, of course, there's been people that get to that point of leanness, but. What we achieved in 94 was strictly because I was obsessed, not because I wanted to show people, but because we lived in an area where we became the Mecca. Every pro superstar was coming out of the where we were in the east side of the United States. Kevin Lavroni, Vince Taylor, Don Long, Jack Smith, Yaz Boyum, Jennifer Greenbaum. I mean, the list kept going, and I mean, it was like holy shit. Then Willie
Stallings,
Willie Stallings came. It was like, okay, I have to get to a point where I can't disappoint. Amin's brother, Adin, went down the southern states. We were all kicking everyone's ass all across the country, and I did not want to disappoint. That's why I would go to Amin's building and run up and down the fucking flights of stairs while they're in their fucking watching TV and dipping and drinking. I mean, that's the craziness, the levels that we went to, but it was because we were such a unbelievable group of people that time. We were, I mean, it was just amazing, the talent that was in that area. It's crazy.
So, Kamali, by your admission, Amin was the original, you know, creator of what we'll call Hell Week, or what people refer to as their peak week.
Yes.
Did this, you know, do you remember the Hell Week? Can you describe it for the people watching? I know the Hell Week because I've worked with Amin. That's how Amin and I became partners here. Can you describe the Hell Week? What did you think about it?
Yeah, well, to preface that, I mean, there was a lot of gurus beginning at that time, too. You know, there was Chad coming up and Dan Duchesne was coming up. There was a lot of things that you could do. But it was Amin that pretty much came up. And I don't care who says anything. I will argue to the rest of my life without this. It was Amin who came up with, you know, you have to not only deplete nutritional wise, you have to deplete your workouts too. You have to completely deplete your body of glycogen. And the only way to do that is not just to go zero carbs and, you know, just do some light workouts and do some cardio. No, it was 100 fucking reps of everything to the point. I mean, that, trust me, I'd rather go be in the front lines of Afghanistan fighting the fucking Taliban with butt naked, okay, and two fucking knives in my hands, okay, than to go through the 7 day out final leg day of the Amin Allied depletion. That was hell on. I mean, you literally close your eyes and you're just moving, but you're not conscious. You're just moving.
Yeah.
You know,
most people pass out.
Most people, you don't have anything to throw up, so you're just heaving.
You're just heaving. Yeah.
And I remember Dina Al Sabah, who actually became a professional bikini and figure. Poor Dina, I had so many women in the gym curse at me and spit at me because I was depleting her for a show, and she went to the corner of the gym and balled up in a fetal position crying because she couldn't take it. And it was normal to me. To me, it was like, I don't give a fuck. I went through the same fucking thing. Yeah. Go in the fucking corner. When you finish crying, come back over here. Yeah. You think the kids are doing that now? Hell no.
They're not. You know what? And that's one thing that, like, you know, I've actually learned from a meme, because a lot of people out there, and it's what it is, it's these so-called gurus with knowledge that's the incorrect knowledge that's getting passed down from generation to generation, and people have this concept that in your depletion phase, your glycogen depletion phase, you're going to do 30 to 40 reps, and it's just these short 20, 25-minute workouts, and they're, you know, I've seen the people do it. I did it before because that's what I was taught, but it's wrong. And I've trained a lot of individuals, and it really works. Amin's Hell Week that he's taught me, it really works. And you have the same thing to say about that.
Yeah. And if you notice now, a lot of the guys a day before the show go to the gym. Rami did it. Dennis James took him to the gym to get a good pump and this and that.
Yeah,
that's because they're pumping that insulin for that fullness. They want that fucking. Here's a little bit off the subject, but I don't know if you guys will agree with me or not, but the way Hunter Labrada looked, in my opinion, if he would have sat in the sauna for 2 hours before prejudging and just put a coat of color on and walk on stage, he would have looked amazing. It would have sucked all the water out, and it would have been just fine. Instead of carb, backstage, pump up, carb, because he wanted that fullness.
That's why he was sweating. That's right. If he would have did what you said, he would look way better. He would have sweated all out. He'd been dry.
That doesn't work on everybody, but I'm just saying for him to see that that sweat and that water that he was holding, that looked like that was water that was sub-cute and just could be pulled right the fuck out.
Just exactly. It's exactly what it was. And it came out because it was quickly in, quickly out. Yeah. The guys doing the insulin these days, it's a window, you know. It's really difficult. You either nail it where everything just happens to be dry at that point, or you become flat really quick and then you got to fill out, and then you may fill out too much. I mean, it's really difficult to do it. How's the pie filling work? You do that seems to be something that's important when you're over 250 pounds.
Well, it was a certain brand and Chad, and it had and I
Certo,
had,
right?
I think that's what it was, and I had this certain type of carb in it that worked perfectly with the insulin. I mean, Chad had done his research, and that's why we use that particular brand. But to be honest with you, and he said only the apple one. He goes, get apple pie filling. I used to get the cherry one too. I didn't give a fuck. I couldn't keep doing the apple, so I was like, fuck it. I'm just going to do the cherry too. But listen, you would think that because you killed yourself and you starved and you got to that point that it's going to taste yummy. Go eat a can of pie filling. And I guarantee you, if you see pie filling again, you're going to throw up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, it's not as easy as you fucking think. And I said this on Palumbo's show one time. I said, and I felt like a bitch. I was like, man, I can't believe I can't finish my food. And then Chad was like, Chad, Chad, when are you going to come see me? He goes, well, I'm in Ronnie's room. Come down real quick. I said, okay. So I went down to Ronnie's room. I walk in. I was like this. He goes, what? I said, Ronnie, half your food is in the trash can. He goes, man, I ain't eating all that goddamn food. Are you crazy? I'm like, wait a second. You're not eating your food either? And Chad goes, well, that's Ronnie. You're different. You got to eat your food. I was like, fuck that. Dumped it right in. Fucking eating all that pie filling. Are you nuts?